What is up, everybody? Sven Diesel here. We're going to be tying up the MPRL. This is a midnight version of Pat's Rubber Legs, a very popular Stonefly Nymph. And we're also using a 90-degree jig hook. This is from Fulling Mill. It's the 6050 in a size 8. We're going to be using a slotted firehole bead. This is a 3.5 millimeter. And as you can see, it comes in a couple different varieties in this black. And then we're going to be using, of course, Semperfli thread. This is their classic wax thread in a 6-aught. And we're going to go ahead and get started. Make sure our hook's in the vise. We're going to do a little ping test here. And of course, the bead's not going to sit when you ping it. It's kind of like a slingshot. But what you want to do with this slotted bead is kind of orient it so that that small hole kind of clicks in. You'll feel it almost click around the hook eye, and then we'll start our thread right behind it, going down about 5-6 wraps, and then going back up to build up a little bit of a thread dam so that slotted bead stays there for the remainder of tying this fly. And then I'll hold my tag end at a 35 degree angle away from the hook shank so that each thread wrap just kind of slides right next to each other, and we'll stop right at the bend. We'll trim out that tag end, and then I'll advance my thread back up to the hook point so we can have a little bit of room to tie in our tail. Now for this, I apologize, I've used a bunch of different materials for these legs. I don't even know who makes these, so if someone knows, please comment below. But it's a black and red flexible leg. It's super hard to control, but it flows and is awesome. So I need to find some more. I'm going to have to do a little research. So I'm just going to snip off 5 of them. The first one I'm going to wrap and figure V it around my thread and work my way into the bend. But as soon as I get to the bend where we ended our thread, I'm going to kind of hold these two fibers so that they're on the top of the shank at this point, but kind of on the sides, kind of on 11, 1 o'clock. And then I'll just hold them with a little bit of pressure. And I'm not doing super tight wraps right there, but then I start to crank down. I don't want a pressure point on my thread. I just want the thread to hold them on the side so they kind of do a V off the back. And we're going to be using, this is the Midnight Chenille, hence the Midnight Pat's Rubber Legs. Is one of my favorite chenilles to use for that dusk time. I've got more trout on this than I've had with other flies at that golden hour when nothing else was working. So it's one I use on the Captain America and a few other patterns, and we're just going to tie it in and get it out of our way and then advance our thread up to about 2/3. So they're 2/3 from the tail to our thread, and then about 1/3 remaining forward with that bead. And then we're going to tie in our legs. Now, I'm going to take 3 of the 5 silicone legs that we cut off, and I'm going to tie them all in at once. I'm going to figure V them around the thread so that they're aligned, and basically tie it in on the top point. I'll do a couple wraps to secure that one wrap, and then this is the first wrap. If you can get this to sit up and over and trap those on the other side, the rest of it's going to be a little bit easy. And I'm going to work on the side with I'm holding in my finger first before I try to really get that other side perfect. That way we're working with one side at a time. And I'm just figure-eighting it and wrapping that thread so that it's coming towards me. So we're building up almost like you're doing like a parachute post on it. If that makes sense, if you've tied a parachute atoms, we're just working our way up that those legs almost like you're building a post. And so they're going to be going out to each side of this fly, and you can see now we've got a nice little thread base right there, and that's going to be super fun to work with and work our chenille through. But patience, and this fly is worth it. So we're going to go ahead and tie in the antennae on this now. I'm just going to do the same thing, figure V our last piece out of the 5 we cut, and I'm going to want it on the bottom of the shank, which is now, since this is a jig hook, it's going to right hook point up. So would this be the top of the shank at this point? In the vise, it's the top of the shank at this point, but technically it's the bottom. And so I'll just tie that in with about a hook eye behind the fire hole slotted bead, and then I will do about 3 or 4 wraps holding them so that they're coming up and over, and just trying to get them to splay like we did on the back, making basically a V shape. And they're going to be kind of in the way at this point, so if you got all these legs, I just do one thread wrap over them, just kind of traps them all, makes wrapping the chenille for the first of this a little bit easier. and you can see how curly these are. I don't know a way to straighten them, but I found that if you go with a heavier rubber leg, it's easier to work with, but it doesn't move as much. And so I really like these legs, and I'll sacrifice and have lots of patience when we get to this point. So we've started wrapping our chenille up to almost the legs. I'm going to release the legs, pull one of the fibers, the one that's furthest back. I'm going to do a wrap over, positioning it towards me so that it's coming out the side of the shank. I'll grab it on the other side, doing the same thing. And since this is a lighter chenille in density, I'm going to do two wraps. If it's a heavier chenille, I'll just do one wrap in between each leg. And then I'll grab the next leg that seems like it's the most likely to be in the middle. I'll wrap up and over with that first wrap, trapping it, being careful not to wrap the other leg going back as well. I'll make sure it's kind of in position. I'll do a second wrap before advancing, and we're wrapping almost up and over the same wrap. And you can see you got a lot of legs that are wanting to get in your way, but that's a good thing. More movement, more flowy, more fun for the fish. So keep the two legs going back now, kind of orient them so that they're in the correct position. We'll grab the last remaining leg, and I'll do a wrap in front of it, and that should leave us with a little bit of a gap in between our front leg and the antennae. And then it looks like here's the fun part, finding that last leg. It's got twisted in there somewhere, and that's I don't want to grab the antennae. It's this one here. Just check which one. There we go. You find it, and then wrap it up and over. You can see, take a breath, don't get frustrated. Take your time. It's going to all work out. And if you pull too hard on those legs, you could potentially pull one out, and you don't want to do that. So we're going to wrap here once we've got those all oriented and get that leg going backwards. And then I'm going to hold the antennae up towards the hook eye. And then I'll try and get a wrap up and over and not trap any legs going forward at this point. If you're using a stiffer leg material, you're not going to have as much of an issue with this at this point. So we'll go ahead and tie this chenille off with a wrap behind and a wrap in front, doing basically a pinch wrap on it, and I'll do it twice. So there we go. We got it up and over, and we'll go ahead and trim that off, get it out of our way. And if it's easier for you to trim your legs to make it a little more manageable, go ahead and do it. For me, I like to leave them longer so that if they do loop into a thread wrap, I can simply pull it out, and it's not too big of an issue. And so we'll do a 3-turn whip finish. It helps to have a larger whip finish tool for this. This is the 4-inch Dr. Slick whip finish tool. I'll make sure my antennae are going as on top as possible, and I'll do a second whip finish. And that's pretty much the fly besides trimming it. I've caught a few smallmouth bass on this. I was kind of stoked. I did a live feed, and everyone said try Pat's rubber legs. It's summer months here, so we have been fishing for smallmouth, and so I was really excited to catch some smallmouth on this fly, exactly how we're doing it. And so I'm just going to trim the antennae and trim the legs roughly the same length as the antennae, and then I'll leave the tail a little bit longer than the antennae and the legs. So just pull them out, trim them a little longer. And this bug, the last step is just to make sure all the legs are oriented going off the sides. If you're using a material for the legs that are stiffer, it's going to look a little better. But once this is in the water, it flows really nice and looks really good. And so this is one of my favorite color combos for woolly buggers and leeches. And so I figured why not try it for Pat's rubber legs. And I had really good luck with it. I actually caught my new personal best smallmouth, but it wasn't on this fly, it was on the fly above it, so hopefully this works as an attractor as well. Thanks for watching. Make sure to click subscribe.